Hi all, in this lecture we will cover second type of chemical reaction, that is decomposition reaction. So let's start second chemical reaction, decomposition reactions. So decomposition reactions are reverse of the combination reaction. Decompose means breakdown. So what was the, if you remember, what was the combination reactions? The reaction in which two or more reactants combine to form a single product. Whereas in decomposition reactions, these are the reactions in which single reactant breaks into two or more simpler products. So these reactions are known as decomposition reactions. Okay, so we write over here, all decomposition reactions are reverse of combination reactions. From the definitions as well as from the examples, you can conclude that combination, there was two or more reactant, whereas product was single. Whereas in decomposition, there would be one single reactant and there would be two or more reactants. Okay, this was the first note point you have to take care. And second is that always energy is required to break the single reactant into two or more products. Okay, so that's why decomposition reactions are endothermic, whereas combination reactions were exothermic. So all decomposition reactions are endothermic. Now what are endothermic reactions? So endothermic reactions are those reactions in which energy will be used by the chemical reaction. Energy will be given to the chemical reaction. Okay. Reactions in which energy is used or given to chemical reaction. Okay. If you remember, in our previous lecture, I told you that all combination reactions are exothermic. So, exit word means to move out. Okay, and endo means get in. You might have heard about these two words, in and exit. In theaters also, these two words are used. If you have to go inside the theater, outside on the door, you would be observing that a letter in is written. Whereas when you go into the any theater and there would be an exit door. So to go out. So exit means same, from same word. Exothermic, thermic means I told you temperature. Okay. So exothermic are the reaction in which energy is released out of by the chemical reaction. Whereas endothermic is in which energy will be used by the chemical reaction. Will give the energy from the outside to the chemical reaction. Okay. So reactions in which energy is used or given to chemical reactions are known as endothermic reaction, and all decomposition reactions are endothermic. Now energy can be given in the form of, can be given to chemical reactions in the form of heat, and such reactions are known as thermal decomposition. Okay, so we'll do three examples of such reactions on the basis of NCERT book. Okay, so if heat is given to break down the single reactant, thermal means again heat and decomposition means breakdown. So if heat will be used to break down the reactant, such reactions are known as thermal decomposition reactions. Now if electricity is used as a energy, then those are known as electrolysis. Such reactions are known as electro electrolysis. Again, electro means electricity, electric current, and lysis means again breakdown. Again, breakdown. Such reactions are known as electrolysis reactions. So we'll do electrolysis of water as a example in decomposition reaction, and this is very important activity also. Now see, if sunlight is used as the form of energy to break down the reactant, such are known as either photo decomposition or photolysis can also be said. Photolysis reactions. Okay, again, now photo means sunlight, photosynthesis. Okay, photo word is used for the sunlight, and lysis again breakdown, decomposition again means breakdown. So we would be using example number in this 5 and example number 6. I'm just giving you the reference. Okay, here 1, 2, 3 examples will be of thermal decomposition. So understood now, the decomposition reactions are in which energy would be used are endothermic. Now let's start with the examples. Now first example is thermal decomposition. Because I told you in first three examples will take energy in the form of heat to break down the reactant. Thermal decomposition of ferrous sulfate crystal. Ferrous sulfate crystal. Now what is crystal? I think you are hearing this word first time in 10th standard. Crystal, let me explain you the meaning of crystal. So crystals are those substances. We'll do this crystal word in the end of the second chapter also. Okay, for the time just understand that crystal is a any substance which contain fixed number of water molecules. Okay, it contain fixed number of water molecules. Like for example, ferrous sulfate crystal, detail of the crystal will do later. Okay, so for the time, ferrous sulfate crystal is, its formula, chemical formula is FeSO4. This is ferrous sulfate, and we use dot to represent the crystal. So dot. Now you should know the difference between, if I write FeSO4 plus 7H2O and FeSO4 dot 7H2O. Okay, you should know the difference. So here these are the two compounds, one is ferrous sulfate and one is 7 molecules of water. These are two compounds. Explanation you can add on by your own. Okay, so these are two compounds, one is ferrous sulfate and another is 7 molecules of water. We have done the rules for writing chemical equations, then we use plus symbol to separate one substance from the other in reactant also as well as in product. So it means plus is for two compounds now. Okay, whereas dot, it means this is a single substance, single substance. That's why separate rule is made that any crystal would be written as dot. Okay, we'll put a dot between these two. So it would have a 7 molecules of water in it, whereas compound would be single. These are not two. That's why you cannot use plus symbol. Okay, so this is a ferrous sulfate crystal, and its color is light green. Light green. So different crystals have different colors. Again, I'm saying that we'll cover later at the end of second chapter, that acid bases and salts. Okay, so ferrous sulfate crystal is light green in color. So what is the chemical reaction? Chemical reaction. Now whenever you heat a ferrous sulfate crystal, FeSO4 dot 7H2O. So I'm heating. Reaction conditions are written on the top of the arrow. So it will lose its water of crystallization. Now I'm writing plus. So this water of crystallization, it will lose in the form of steam, okay, vapors. So you will left only ferrous sulfate. So its color is light green, observe for the observation. And this would be white in color, ferrous sulfate white. Now if we still heating, if we continue to heat further. Now ferrous sulfate, if we heat it further, you can also use delta symbol, then it will form ferric oxide, and along with two gases you will observe, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. To balance the reaction, I'll put two over here. Now reaction is balanced. Okay, now what is ferric oxide? Its color will be reddish brown. Reddish brown color. How you will learn these colors? Ferric oxide, you might have observed that if you cut an apple and keep it for open for few minutes, you will turn, it will turn, you will see that it will turn reddish brown. That is because that iron which is present in the apple that react with oxygen and ferric oxide is formed, and that would be reddish brown. Likewise, you can learn it. Okay, and along with this compound, two gases will be observed. Now what would be the observation? Observations of this reaction. One would be change in color, right? Change in color from light green to reddish brown. Reddish brown. Now where that white color have gone? Here it was light green, then white, then from white to reddish brown. Then why I am writing light green to brown? Where this white color went? Why I am not writing this white? Because it is intermediate product. If I start, starting product is ferrous sulfate crystal and final product is ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. Okay, so these were intermediate. I have started with ferrous sulfate crystal and started heating. So white color which is found, that would be intermediate. It cannot be even observed that it is turning white. Suddenly from light green and finally you would have a reddish brown in the test tube. Okay, so observation is one is change in color from light green to reddish brown. I'm writing, so why light green, that you can tell, and what why reddish brown, that also you can tell from the chemical reaction, that this reddish brown is due to formation of ferric oxide and this light green is of ferrous sulfate crystal. And second is evolution of gases. Evolution of gases. Now again I am telling you, we have done previously that colorless gases are evolving, but you will not be able to guess the gases except when you test them in the laboratory. Certain tests are there for to test each and every gas, like for the hydrogen gas we have seen that it burns giving pop sound. Okay, and carbon dioxide gas we have seen that it turns lime water milky. Now this is the test of the sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide gases, that these will give you the pungent smell of burning sulfur, which gives pungent smell of burning sulfur. Okay, so this is the test of sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide gases. So two observations. So for every action I told you, reaction, you might have two observations at least. So this was the first chemical reaction. Second, thermal decomposition of limestone. Second time you are hearing this word. Previously we have seen that when slake lime is treated with carbon dioxide, whitewashing reaction, it will form calcium carbonate and water. Okay, so that calcium carbonate is known as limestone. Calcium carbonate. Now I am doing its decomposition by heating it again, or delta you can use. Now I told you, in maximum cases where carbonate will be in reactant form, carbon dioxide will be on right hand side, okay, as a product. So it will form quicklime and carbon dioxide. So this is a limestone, common name, and this is quicklime. Again quicklime is coming second time and carbon dioxide gas is evolved. Again this is a decomposition because single reactant is broken into two products. Okay, now again observation, evolution of gas which turns lime water milky. This is the test of carbon dioxide. Which turns lime water milk. Third, thermal decomposition of lead nitrate. What will be its chemical formula? PbNO3 2. So when lead nitrate is heated, it will form lead oxide, yellow color substance, and it is white. And along with this, brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide gas, and along with one more gas, oxygen, will be released out. Okay, for balancing, this is important to balance. Okay, this reaction is very important to balance. First time you will not be able to balance, and you can try by your own. Okay, so it's better if you remember this reaction. Okay, how to balance it. Okay, so lead is 2, I'm putting 2 over here. Lead is 2, nitrogen is 2 2 2 4. Now finally oxygen, 3 2 6, 6 2 12, 2 8 10 plus 2. Now reaction is balanced. Okay, so observation of this reaction is brown fumes of, now again test of H2 we have done, burning with pop sound. Test of CO2 we have seen, turns lime water milky. Okay, test of O2 we will do, that will support combustion. Okay, and now nitrogen dioxide, it will give you the brown fumes. Okay, brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide gas are absorbed. So this is a observation. Okay, so in this lecture we have covered thermal decomposition reactions, examples of three thermal decomposition reactions, and introduction to the decomposition reactions. In next coming lectures we'll include electrolysis as well as photo decomposition. Okay, so for the time, bye.